Hey, what's up guys? Jeremy here. In this video, we will learn how to use the measurement tool to extract valuable information from the 3D models we just imported. Let's get started. For this example, let's open the measure tool subsection of module 5 3D models. Here you can first of all open the rectangle, 1000 by 700. Okay, cool. As expected, this 3D model was imported exactly where the station origin is, right here. So you can find the measurement tool under Tools and then Measure. We already touched on it a bit, but let's go over the different options you have here. So you have a general toggle button here to activate or deactivate the feature. That can be cool if you want at some point here. You can see we have a small X following us. If you click on something, it will kind of pick the position you got. But if you were to just put it down or toggle it off, it will disappear. So that's kind of a way to toggle on, toggle off the feature. Then you have the extract snap on arc center. This will, as we already used it, snap on the center point of an arc. So we can select either a circle or a piece of an arc, and it will select the center point. Fairly simple. You have snap on curve, midpoint, and edges. It will snap the midpoint or the end of a curve that you selected. And here, snap on any point. It will snap on any point you can find at a corner of a surface. For those to work, though, you need to either have automatically extract surface corners or automatically extract surface edges activated. Otherwise, they are just snapping on curves. And if you don't have curves in your station, we'll talk about curves later in a future video. But if you don't have them, or if you don't have the automatic extraction feature activated, you won't be able to snap on anything. So even if I was to select here, snap on midpoint and edge, I'm not able to snap on anything. But here, if I activate the automatically extract surface edges, now you will see a kind of a silent line appearing at the edge as soon as I'm coming close to the edge, and it wants to either snap to one of the ends or to the center point here. So I can measure the position of this center point here. It's at 350, 0, 10 here with respect to the station origin. In clear selection here. Underneath you have select or detect plane. Here, this does not require any of those activated. It will simply detect, oops, I didn't select it. It will simply detect a plane and try to figure out the center point of it as precisely as possible. It works if you have a relatively, let's say, normal surface, but if you have a weird shaped surface, it might not give you the really center point of it. You then have a snap on detect cylinder, so it will snap on the center axis of the cylinder. And you then have here detect cones. So cones will let you pick the tip of a cone. So let's say if you were to try to find the tip of a drill bit, you could do it with this here. Here you have automatically extract surface corners. So a corner is defined by three or more surfaces coming together at one point. And here you have extract surface edges. This is when two surfaces get in contact at some point. Clear selection and then absolute. For now, we will keep absolute activated. In the next video, I will show you what's the difference between having absolute activated and not activated. So let's start by just measuring this 3D model real quick. We know it should be measuring 1000 by 700. So let's just verify that. So click and select one point here. Click select the other point here, and you have the position of the first point, position of the second point, distance written down here and written down here. You can copy the position of the points you selected. And if you go from one point to the other, you will see here it will change the values. You can select these points and you can select or copy here the distance between those two points also. Clear, if we go and we select instead here the midpoint, select midpoint here, 350. That's what we were expecting. This part here is 700 wide. So 350 makes a lot of sense. So let's clear the selection here. And let's go to another example here. So if you bring in, I don't know, the linear rail, so I'm gonna delete this rectangle here, just clean out the colors as I showed you before. Let's go for a small redo in case you forgot. Otherwise, you can look at the split object video. So this is the one just before this one here. Okay, let's say that you want to put the robot right here in the top, but you want to make sure that it's right in the middle. So what you can do here is go to Tool, Measure. If you select the detect plane and select this one here, it will give you the center point of that plane here. So with that center point, you can copy this value here, and then let's import a robot, doesn't matter which one. So let's go for the Fanuc, for a KUKA, let's say. This one here, perfect. It's in a weird position, it was just imported there. So if I double click the robot base and then apply or paste the value I had on my clickboard, which was the measured point, you can see here that the base of the robot does match with the center of that rail. So now I only need to reorient the robot to match the orientation of the station here, and the robot is right in the center point. In the next video, we will explore a bit more how you can use that to really set up your different robots in the right spot in your station. That will save you a lot of time. So don't forget to watch the next video. Okay, so here for the next example, I will just open the organize box that we used previously. Remember when I was trying to use it, I was trying to pick those two here center point to figure out the distance between those two boxes. So if I go tool and then measure, I can select plane here, and I feel like I can select this plane here and this plane here, and it should give me the distance between those two planes. But instead it's giving me like zero. The reason is when you select detect plane, what you're selecting on really, it's not really the center point. What you're selecting is the plane. So you're comparing one plane with one another. In this case, both planes are on the same height in Z. So that means that the distance between the planes is indeed 0 millimeters. If you want to know the distance between those two objects, what you can do instead is select midpoint here, select one midpoint here, another midpoint here, and now you know that it's 125. There's 125 millimeters in between those two points here. Okay. Perfect. One last thing I want to show you. If I go back to the station here, and if I, let's say, delete all of this, I can select the two axis linear here, bring that here, and let's say I need to, I'm gonna clean that up real quick, delete mesh. Let's say that I want to bring the robot here. If I simply select tool and then measure, select the plane, and select this one here, you can see that the center point that is detected is here. So that doesn't make sense. Like I said, this is not a, let's say, nice circle, nice oval, nice square. It has some spike coming out. So the algorithm just figure out where the plane is. It can't figure out where the center of that is really. So what you can do if you want to find the center point of this here is the following. Clear selection. Then I'm going to go select snap on midpoint and edges. I'm going to select one point here, midpoint of this one here. Select one midpoint here. That creates a line in between. That just tells me like between this point and this point, there's 510 millimeters. But here you might see that there's a create geometry button appearing. So if you click on it, it will literally create a line. In this case, it's a bit fine line. It's like magenta. But if you clear selection, now you have a line that you can select to figure out the center point. So now this is the center point of this and this here. So now you have your center point position if you want to bring in the robot. Very handy, I would say. So, okay, that's everything for this video. In the next one, I will show you how you can use this method to quickly position robots and parts in your station. And I will show you how the absolute option behaves. In any case, have a great day, guys.